Shalom to my Israelite family and all of those who are listening. Shabbat shalom to you all. We have a very important lesson that we will be studying today. So I pray that all are strengthened and edified by this message. Before we get started, I want to give all praises and honor to the Most High Yah and his wonderful son, Yeshua HaMashiach. If you are new to the Hebrew language, I said I want to give praise and honor to God. Some people call him God. Some people call him Yahuwah, which is actually Hebrew. And his son, some people call him Jesus Christ. Some people call him Yahawashai. Some people call him Yeshua, but he is our Messiah, he is our King, and he is coming again for us. So I give all praise and honor to him first and foremost. And we have a lesson to get to. I pray that my lips and every word that I speak will be guided by Him and His Holy Spirit. And I pray for all the families that are listening and that will listen in the future. Peace and blessings to you all. Okay, let's get started. Okay. Whew. Take three. Here we go. Yah knew that we would be living in a world full of wickedness, full of confusion, full of temptation. And that's why He called us special and told us to come out of them, meaning the world, and not follow what the world is doing, because we are His special people. And I know that my listeners, I know you guys know that because you've participated in a Sabbath lesson where we spoke about how the Most High Yah views us as special. He views us as special, family. So I'm going to share my screen again and we're going to dive into this lesson. I know that I may have people listening from various age groups, but we all have probably heard about what happened recently at the Travis Scott concert. We all have probably heard what happened. And so I want to remind our family that Isaiah 43 and 4 tells us, says, thou wast precious in my sight. Thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. He said, we are precious in his sight, and we are a special people. We are a special people. So with that, it means we can't do what other people do. We shouldn't want to. And I want you guys to think about something that you really value. Like my daughter, my youngest daughter, she has a favorite stuffed animal. It's a panda bear. Now, she has a lot of toys and stuffed animals, but that panda bear, she's been having it for several years and it's special to her. She sleeps with it closer to her than the other stuffed animals. And if we go somewhere on a trip or something, or just somewhere in the car to the store, she can't take all of her toys with her. But throughout the years, you usually could find her looking and searching for that panda bear. And she would take the special one that she valued with her and keep it close to her at all times. So I wonder, children and adults, family that are listening, think about something that you have that's special to you, that stands out from the other things. Do you treat it the same as you do everything else? Or do you set it apart and do something special with it? If you want to share, you can put it in the chat. I may not be quick responding in the chat, since I'm teaching, but I will do my best to respond. And if I don't respond live during the show, I will respond afterwards. I believe that I saw my beloved sister A Diamond in the chat, as well as my beloved sister Nitya. I want to say Shabbat Shalom to both of my beloved sisters, and thank you for listening. I know my children are listening. Shabbat Shalom to my children and my wonderful husband. Thank you guys for your support. And Shabbat Shalom to everyone who's listening in the background and may not be putting their names in the chat or saying anything in the chat. I thank you for joining us today. So, like I was saying, as a special people, we have to consult the Most High all the time for every decision that we make. This is what our forefathers did. And every time they did this, they were victorious. They had peace. They had safety. If they consulted the Most High and listened to his instructions, then things went well with them. We must learn to hear from him and listen to him. But here's the challenge. How do we do this? As children, I know I shared the story about Samuel. And if you guys remember, when Samuel was a little boy, the Most High Yah was speaking to him. He was actually calling his name. Samuel, and you can find this story, and I don't have it for this lesson, but I'm gonna go ahead and give it. I'm sorry I don't have the scripture on the slide, but for those who want to remind themselves of the story, you can find this in 1 Samuel chapter 3. 1 Samuel chapter 3, okay? But Samuel did not know how to really discern the Most High Yah's voice. So the prophet Eli gave him guidance. He told him exactly what to do when he hears a voice calling his name. He said that is the Lord speaking to him because he called it three times. So let's go a little deeper and talk about how we hear from Yah. This is so important because we have events going on in the world today where we desperately must know how to hear from the Most High Yah. at all times. I'm talking about every decision in your life. So there are several examples in the Bible. Today, we're going to dive deep into one example, but I'm going to highlight six examples before we dive into the one that really aligns to our lesson today. So how do we hear from the Most High? Because the Most High loves to speak to his people. He's always speaking. It's our responsibility to hear and listen and obey him. One way that we all know is we can hear from the Most High through his word. And where do we find his word? In the Bible. We can hear from the Most High through his word, which we find his word in the Bible. That is his word. Here's a little fun fact. Yeshua is also the word. Ooh, we'll get into that on another lesson as well, because that's a whole lesson by itself. But let's read this scripture. Psalms 119, verse 105. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. What this means, family, is that the word of the Most High is what guides us through every step in our lives. So if you want to know how to hear from the Most High, the Bible, that's a great place to start and finish and just stay in the Bible, his word. All right. Number two, prayer. In addition to reading the word of the Most High, Yah, we should all be praying every day. Really, all day, throughout the day, not just in the morning or at night. Because listen to James chapter 5, verse 16. It says, the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Availeth means to accomplish, to complete. So when you pray and you're a righteous man or woman or little boy or little girl, James told us that your prayers will accomplish much. So we got the Bible, prayer. Here's the third way that we hear from the Most High, through his Holy Spirit. The book of John, chapter 14, verse 26 lets us know, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. Some people say Holy Spirit, some people say Holy Ghost. So that's the same thing. Whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. So the Holy Spirit is a teacher, and he helps us to remember what the Most High Yah has said in his word, and that helps to guide us. All right, I'm going to give you guys three more, and the last one is going to be the one we're really going to focus in on, okay? So the fourth one, we had the Bible or the word, we had prayer, we had the Holy Spirit. Now we're on number four, which is the prophets. You can hear from the Most High and understand what he is speaking through his prophets. Can anyone name a few of the prophets? Children, tell your parents the name of some of the prophets that you know. We know Isaiah. We know Samuel. We just talked about him. Who else? We know Ezekiel. We know Jeremiah. These are all your forefathers, your great, 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 great grandfather and uncle and cousins. So many prophets, right? I just named a few. Those are examples of the prophets. Let's read what Proverbs 1:5 says. It says, a wise man will hear and will increase learning, and a man of understanding shall attain unto wise counsels. Not just anybody. The prophets gave wise counsel because it came straight from Yah to them, and then they gave it to the people. So wise counsel, that's very important. All right, so we have the way that we can hear from the Most High. We have the Bible or his word, prayer, the Holy Spirit, the prophets, number five, through dreams. Speaking of the prophets, the Most High would speak to many of them in dreams. And I'm sure we will do a lesson on dreams. Just all, we can do lessons on each of these just by itself, okay? But do you have dreams? Maybe you can start keeping a journal and you can write the dreams that you have. Because I guarantee you the Most High is speaking to you in your dreams. And you know, he spoke to Samuel when he was asleep, and Samuel thought maybe he was dreaming, but he wasn't. So sometimes it can get a little tricky because you're like, am I dreaming? Did I just hear that? He can speak to you when you're awake or when you're asleep in your dreams. How exciting is that? Let's see what Acts 2 and 17 has to say. Acts 2 verse 17 reads, and it shall come to pass in the last days, saith God, I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. See? All right. So I want everybody to remember all of these because I don't want anyone feeling like, I can't hear the Most High. The Most High don't speak to me. I don't know what. I don't want anyone to feel that way because we have ways that he's always speaking through his word, through prayer, through the Holy Spirit, through his prophets, in dreams. And last but not least, because this is where we're focusing today, through events, things that are happening around you, or if not in your direct vicinity, in the world. And you are a part of the world, you live in the world, but we're not of the world, but we live in the world right now. So events. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 9 reads, only take heed to thyself and keep thy soul diligently, lest thou forget the things which thine eyes have seen, and lest they depart from thy heart all the days of thy life. But teach them thy sons and thy sons' sons. I love the scriptures that keep reminding us the importance of teaching our children, which is something that the Most High put in my heart to love doing. I love teaching children. So this is a very special scripture to me. But I want to draw your attention to what it says. It says, don't forget what your eyes have seen. So don't forget what's happening around you and listen to the Most High through his son, Yeshua. They are speaking to us, even in these events. So today, let's focus on hearing Yah in the events that are happening around us. Look at this picture. Before COVID, and interestingly, even in the pandemic, people go to concerts. People are still going to concerts. Now, you guys may have heard about a concert that just happened recently with an artist, and the Seek Yah's Way is going to be honest, I'm not familiar with this artist. I could not tell you one song that he sings. I'm not in the know as regarding this modern music. That's why y'all always hear me playing 80s and 90s music, because that's the music I grew up on and that's the music that I love. I don't know about this music. But anyway, some tragic events happened at this concert. This performer's name is Travis Scott. And there were several people who attended his concert. I would imagine when they woke up that morning, they were probably looking forward to seeing him perform. They couldn't wait. And I wonder, did any of them consult the Most High and ask, is this something that I should be doing? Is this somewhere that you want me to go? I just wonder. I don't know anyone who went to the concert personally, so I cannot say for sure that they did or didn't. But what I am saying to my family that's listening is that you must always consult the Most High. You can use one of the six strategies we just discussed. Let's see what the book of Proverbs says about this type of thing. Chapter 6, verse 16 lets us know that there are six things that the Most High Yah hates. Even seven are an abomination unto him. Woo! I pulled out verse 18 because it says, feet that be swift, that means quick, in running to mischief. Mischief, that's a bad choice. That's something that's not good. So at this concert, there were lots of people running, and they were not concerned about others around them. And it got really, really bad. People were hurt, and some people even died. So I wonder, again, leading up to the concert, you see some images here of Travis Scott, and he doesn't really look like a nice person that a child of the Most High Yah should be going and listening to and celebrating. I'm just saying, by looking at him, some things can be discerned just by looking. These are images from the actual concert. You can see the flames. It was made up to look like the people were entering into hell. These are some pictures of some of the advertisements before the concert happened to tell people that it was about to start or to buy their tickets. These are the things that they were viewing. And it got so bad that people's bodies had to be lifted up in the crowd and passed over other bodies to try to get medical attention. So these are just some pictures I want you guys to see. Because when we don't consult and listen to the Most High Yah, the end result is never good. The end result is never good. You can see in some of these images, people are being crushed and pushed and trampled, just stepped on and run over like their bodies didn't matter. Because sadly, I don't think that their bodies mattered to the people around them. The people were just wanting to quickly make it to the front of the area, the concert area. And it's very sad. This picture of this young lady, like in the top, in the middle, she is trying to tell them to stop the concert, but they didn't listen. They kept performing while people were being stepped on and pushed. This was not a good thing. This was not a good thing. And I'm pretty sure that many of the people there wished that they didn't go. I know I would have wished that I stayed at home. I know that for sure. So many lives were lost at this concert that just took place last week in Houston, Texas. Some of my family listening lives in Texas. Some even live in Houston. So this is not something that is happening way far, far away, or it happened long, long ago. Nope. This just happened last week, right here in some of our backyards. But guess what? I said this isn't something that happened long, long ago, right? And it's not. But something similar happened in the Bible. Whoa. Would you believe that? This story is not new. Something similar happened in the Bible. And you guys know that we always can learn and grab wisdom from the word of the Most High Yah. So let's jump into the scriptures so that we can avoid making the same mistakes of our ancestors. And maybe we can prevent events like the tragedy that happened at the Travis Scott concert for our children. Okay? Because some people, if they don't know the Most High Yah, if they're not reading the word, they're not going to know that they need to ask him and they need to listen. They're going to go, they're going to be in these crowds with their hands up, singing the songs because they don't know. But when you know, then you can avoid these mistakes. If you have your Bibles, please open up to 2 Kings chapter 10. 2 Kings chapter 10. And I am going to start at verse 18 because something similar happened to our forefathers. Yes, the Most High Yah is giving us instructions in his word for things that are happening in 2021. It is vital that you read his word. I have this image up here because I wanted to show you an example of an ancient temple, an ancient place of idol worship. See, when you go to a concert, there's many, many thousands of people, and they're all there for that one person. And in a way, they are worshiping. The person tells them, put their hands up. They put their hands up. Person tells them, swing your arms side to side. They do it. Person tells them, say, hey. They hold their microphone out in the crowd. The people say what? Hey. They have full control of the crowd. Okay. And we are not supposed to do that. We're not supposed to follow the crowd. We're not supposed to do that. So let's jump into the scriptures. And you guys read along with me or listen. 2 Kings chapter 10. And I'm going to start at verse 18. And before I do that, let me just let you guys know. At this time, our people, our ancestors, the Israelites, they are not doing so well with their choice making. They have been making some bad choices. King David, we all know, was a good king. He loved the Most High Yah. He desired to build a temple for the Most High Yah. And the Most High said, I'm going to let your son Solomon build it, which Solomon did, which was a good choice. Good job, Solomon. But he also made some bad choices. And those bad choices led to the kingdom being split. Ooh, and it just went down from there. So by the time we get to 2 Kings chapter 10, we have Jehu, who is in power. And he did something that was pretty good. He killed a man who did not serve the Most High. You may know his name. His name is Ahab, and his wife's name was Jezebel. We can talk about that later. All of these are like whole lessons, but I just want you to have a reference for what we're about to get into. And so after Jehu did that, he was on a roll destroying things, okay? And then we pick it up in verse 18. And Jehu gathered all the people together and said unto them, Ahab served Baal a little, but Jehu shall serve him much. Baal is not a true god. He's a false god. And Ahab and his wife Jezebel worshiped him. Okay, I'm picking it up at verse 19. Now therefore, call unto me all the prophets of Baal, all his servants and all his priests. Let none be wanting, for I have a great sacrifice to do to Baal. Whosoever shall be wanting, he shall not live. But Jehu did it in subtlety. Ooh, that means he was cool and he was tricking the people. To the whosoever shall be wanting, they shall not live. He did it cool and tricking the people to the intent that he might destroy the worshipers of Baal. So he had a plan. And Jehu said, proclaim a solemn assembly for Baal. And they proclaimed it. And Jehu sent through all Israel, and all the worshipers of Baal came, so that there was not a man left that came not. And they came into the house of Baal, and the house of Baal was full from one end to the other. Kind of looking like this bottom picture. Kind of looking like this concert picture. They packed in there to worship this false god. Okay, it was full. It said from one end to the other. Verse 22, and he said unto him that was over the vestry, bring forth vestments for all the worshipers of Baal. And he brought them forth vestments. And Jehu went, and Jehonadab the son of Rechab into the house of Baal, and said unto the worshipers of Baal, search and look that there be here with you none of the servants of the Lord, but the worshipers of Baal only. So guess what? They went through the crowd and said, you worship the Most High, Yah? You love Yeshua? You love him? Okay, get out of here. What about you? Who you here for? Oh, Baal, cool. You can stay. Hey, little girl over there, do you love Yeshua? You do? Girl, get out of here. They went through the crowd and they tried to see who was here for Yah and Yeshua. And those people, they said, get out. They said, if you're here for Baal, cool. You where you need to be. Oh my goodness. Let's pick it up in verse 24. And when they went in to offer sacrifices and burnt offerings, Jehu appointed 80 men without and said, if any of the men who I have brought into your hands escape, he that letteth him go, his life shall be for the life of him. And it came to pass, as soon as he had made an end of the offering, the burnt offering, that Jehu said to the guard and to the captains, go in and slay them. Let none come forth. And they smote them with the edge of the sword. And the guard and the captains cast them out and went to the city of the house of Baal. And they brought forth the images out of the house of Baal and burned them. And they break down the images of Baal and break down the house of Baal and made it a drought house unto this day. Family. He gathered all the people together just to destroy them. They thought they were going to a Baal concert. They thought they were going to a fun time. But they did not consult the Most High Yah. They didn't even worship or believe in him. So they thought it was all fun and games. But everyone that day that worshiped the false god, they were destroyed. They were killed. And so, family, I want us as a people to be focused, to be diligent in teaching our children how to hear from the Most High Yah, how to discern his voice, how to know when to follow and when not to follow. The crowd usually leads to destruction, and it's so critical that we ensure that our children are covered, that they are safe, that they know the Most High Yah's voice and another voice they refuse to follow. Family, I really, really thank you for listening to those scriptures. I hope that you will go back and study those scriptures and share that story with your children. And I look forward to seeing what you do for our Sabbath assignment, which is coming up right now. I will share my screen again. And let me make sure you guys are able to see the assignment.
Pick it up, pick it up.
Okay.
Pick it up, back on the scene. Pristine and clean. You can try, but don't work because you can't intervene. We be the outcast, down for the settle. Won't play rock. Open the door, you best believe we're sliding through it swiftly. Niftily, we can make it hip to be. What we're on, what we be. Be the epitome, do da dippity. So now I dwell just to say you're plain. Pull your cup, cause I got the container. Pass the plate up, cross the fader. Black sheep can play like the Sony innovator. Never the traitor, party of flavor. And you can get a scoop later. You can get with this, or you can get with that.
Of you for joining us for the children's Sabbath lesson, this or that. Please feel free to, let me put the assignment back on the screen. Hopefully it showed long enough for you to see it. But But parents, I want to encourage you to speak with your children. Make sure that you know what's going on if they go to school or if they're away from you for any time. Even if they're with you, you still don't know what could be going on in their minds, what they have questions about, what they're wondering about. And help them to know how to hear from the Most High, how to hear His voice, so that they can have discernment and have direction in life. Okay? So the Sabbath assignment is, children, think about something that's happening in our world currently. There's so much. There is so much. We are in a pandemic. You know, you have people making bad choices with drugs, people making bad choices with the friends they're choosing, with who they like and who they don't like, and the music, and how they dress. I mean, it's just, there's so much, okay? But I want you to think about something that's going on in the world. Using your art supplies, you can draw a picture, make a Play-Doh creation if you have Play-Doh. You can write a story or a song. But I want you to think about how you're going to focus in on listening to the Most High more. So in your story or your picture or your song or your Play-Doh creation, depict yourself listening and obeying the Most High's voice and not the world. And then, if you want, you can share your work with us at seekyahsway@gmail.com. We love to receive your pictures. Thank you so much to those who have sent pictures. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful creations. Thank you. And we look forward to seeing you all next Sabbath. Until then, make sure that you're reading your word. Make sure that you're praying. Children, listen and obey your parents. And Shabbat Shalom, family. Bye.